Welcome back. Satisfactory. All right. I am so glad you're here. We have a minor, just a minor project today. Right? We want to add a few versatile framework production units to our location here. Man, I'm getting flashbacks. When I originally built this, I didn't have blueprint delete mode or nudge capability. It would click on it. It would be off by one little bit. Then you'd have to redo the whole thing. But you have to delete everything by hand. Now you have nudge and blueprint delete. So much easier. And you can definitely move faster when you know that you can fix your mistakes relatively easily. And I guess this is a little bit more about the next project part, the assembly directory, but we do need to get some of these extra modular frames out of here. So that's the reason why we're doing this, is because we can make versatile frames, which will help us with our next project part. But then we can also siphon off a few extra modular frames to help us with our assembly director. Let's see here. If we can go down here. I was going to take these off of power save mode, but I think I'll leave all the ratios the way that it currently is. So when you start messing with those ratios, you just, ugh. It's a chain reaction. That's a miss. I don't even have to let it fully build to know it. Let's just check to make sure these things are receiving materials. Thinking about it, 450 is gonna be a lot. So this top level might not have a ton. But it'll be ready when it's ready. You know what is a good point? See, these are Mark 3 belts or lifts. Let's put Mark 4 lifts in here. Yep, I'm already seeing more. Let's double check the belts on this side before we get to building more. Yep, same thing. We should build the power cables first. That's blocking access or easy access to those power cables. I might have to check the belts feeding this. See if we can upgrade these to Mark 4 belts as well. Spend a little time walling this in and then we'll call it done. my style for building monoliths has definitely improved. All right, that's the coal line. Let's get the iron line. Upgraded. I wonder why are we still having delays. I bet there's a Mark 3 lift somewhere in here. Well, you look at that. I went really hardcore this day. Basically built this into the ground. How did I even build this? Problem is this is going to be limited by how did I even build this? Okay, well, that might be this where it is. same-ish over here. Looks to me like this belt needs more coal. Rude. Where do we want to add this, though? Well, that's probably our best bet right there. I think we'll have a pretty big upgrade. Oh, looks like we caught up already. That was quick. Well, that was this side that terminates inside of a Mark III lift that I cannot understand how I built it. Nope, it's even harder on that side. Alright, well. Lesson learned. Don't clip through things that you can't delete, move, or otherwise alter. So this line needs to really be good so we can claim some improvement. We'll just merge on here. This one is obviously overloaded. We'll just take half from you.
I don't know, have a good day.
The stoppage is moving away from us, so that is telling us something. I could re-merge back onto this line if I really wanted to. Split off of here. Oh, wait. This is a totally different heights. Nope, nope. This one's full now. So we're all good. That's all good. I forgot how colorful I set this up. You know, to get the actual modular frames out of here is gonna be an absolute nightmare. Because all they do is they feed directly into this machine. I think we're going to call it. We're going to have to figure out a different way to get more frames. I mean, we've got a factory that makes frames. I feel like I was trying to take a shortcut by bleeding this. One thing I have learned for the next time through is if we are going to have byproducts as part of the factory, we need to plan for that. How about these auto saves? They're getting serious. It's actually coming out kind of cool. Plus, I don't know that there's a huge surplus beyond the first couple of levels when it's getting full access to the construction resources necessary to make modular frames. That could be justification to peel off one of these as opposed to trying to do it for every single level. Of course, that would then only add four or five per minute. These guys are consuming 15 per minute each, which is 60 total. Well, if nothing else, this versatile framework this is good for us because we need it in the not in the electromagnetic control rod, but in the engine, I think it's called. Let's see. Well, no. What are you called? Field generator. Right here is where we need it. We need 20,000 of those. Nope, we need 10,000 of those. 5 makes 2. We need 4, so we need 2,000, which means we need 10,000 of these. Let's see if I have the silicone steel to finish this. Well, I guess we're at the middle of a steel factory, so we should have access to all the steel we need. Obviously, I use the frame motif because it's part of the versatile frame. An extra 1.7 per minute. If we can get all the resources in here. This is going to be a heck of a manifold. Yeah, they're going to struggle to get... resources to the top of this tower. This one's only looking for 10 per minute. I'm still thinking about this Mark III lift over here. How the heck did I build this? I built the floor and then somehow just got really lucky with being able to connect it all. I do see another problem though. This isn't being fed a sufficient amount of iron. Oh, that's right. Iron is also being dropped off here. What is going on? Oh, that's right. There's two levels. Oh, it's all coming back to me now. Right, and then I had this iron mine right here, and I put it into all of them as kind of a load balance situation. Holy moly. A long time ago. It looks to me like we could share a little bit of the wealth here. This one's not even phased by the surplus we're taking. Ugh, I don't know if we can fit any more in here. Oh no, this belt's full now. We're good. Two modular frames. I don't think I want to do anything else here. I kind of like how this has resolved itself. The only question is, do we try to fix that Mark III connection, which we know is lurking under here? You know what? It's too risky. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to do my best to not worry about it. I'm going to just learn the lesson to not build things that clip into the map. Because you will end up in a situation where you don't feel comfortable further fixing it. So the only problem we have left is that we've got 60 modular frames per minute being consumed. But we're not producing, we're producing like a quarter of that. Each of these machines are slowed by right around 25%. And they all have everything else, they just don't have modular frames. Somewhere in here, there's a hatchery that keeps respawning. These last two are maxed out on iron. We could turn this into a double for our modular frame factory. Currently, it's just getting this single line, which is also being used to create iron ingots. Over here, as part of our iron ingot factory, over here. So we don't want to decrease the amount of that because these iron ingots are getting flipped and shipped all over this little area. But if we could add another line of iron ore to this industrial storage container, we could probably dramatically increase I'm pretty sure that the only thing we're using these modular frames are for the construction of heavy modular frames. I don't think I need to merge these now since they're both going to the same location. This splitter. And then at that point, they get split, one going out to the iron ingot refinery and one going over to the modular frame factory. This side is just having trouble. Getting iron. So let's see here. Yeah, I think our modular factory should be much happier now. So now, the last thing that we should check is our iron road. This is something I haven't visited since we set it up. $896 iron. 254 iron. Aha! Miner Mark II. Here's our upgrade point. We upgraded these three Miner Mark IIs. Maybe slap some faster belt on there. That would get us more frames as well. You know, I probably should also, all right, we've got what we need. We've got our shopping list. Well, I might. No, hold on. We're gonna use the stuff. I know I've got some stuff over on the Crater Lakes that we can use to help us make this happen. At the very least, we need to grab those supercomputers out of the supercomputer factory.
good day.
We actually have a lot of good stuff over here. Thing that I'm considering now is, do we have a couple of power shards? Oh boy. I played this game a lot and I still realize there are whole sections of this map that I have never been to. Like some of this map regrew. Wait a minute, what happened here? It takes two miners to make one of these. If I had two miners on me when I went to upgrade this... Oh, I've got to have three miners on me to execute the upgrade. Hmm. put Mark V belts down for everybody. Why is this red? Ah, these are just normal spots. All right, so it looks like if we want to maximize this little space now, all we need is a couple of power shards. Like that one might be in a cave somewhere. Oh, there it is. Ooh, and it's a yellow. Perfect. I liked it when the mask came on and the filter was applied and you would hear the breathing. It's a clear indication that you were in a toxic area. Now, you just have to look down and see that your filters are being used. Just enough to make a craft bench. Well, we're pushing 1,800 iron ore per minute now. It's enough to at least give more. Put more into the system, you know what I mean? Ooh. Yeah, let's upgrade. Do a lift upgrade as well. Yes. That's good stuff. And then there's a little piece of belt left to upgrade. Thirteen items per minute. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. Let's quickly check this. Grab anything that wasn't supposed to be in there and out of there. Gonna check the vehicles that were in the area, make sure they don't have anything in them that they don't need to have. Okay. Oof, that was almost bad. But we're okay. One little misclick. I just want to get all the ore that's stored down here out and about where it belongs, so we can also check to see if this is running. I see. So I wanted all of these to feed one of these. So I put them all into this first one. And then these other two miners get their own sort of overflow. The only downside here is if this fills up all the way, then this miner only has one way to unload. But I suppose that's okay. Because that would mean this whole thing filled up. So we're moving 2,500 items per minute. This is the most we can get out of here because they're all overclocked times three. They all have the best belts. They all have the best outputs. There's no filling of the buffer. So that's working perfectly. All right. That's going to be the last time that we need to look at the heavy modular frames, versatile frame section of this factory for this playthrough. So now all we have to do is we could probably start putting the assembly directors into the hub. We'll do that next time. We need to get them into the hub, and then we probably should build out the hub so things get split into the right locations. Let's see if we can wait for the truck to come by. All right. I think we're done. All that should result in more iron making its way to this factory. Oh yeah, that looks good. We'll see how the top one's doing. I at least see green lights up here. Okay. 100% construction. It's only 2 per minute, though. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Ugh. That means we're making 16 per minute. Which is enough for one of these to run full time, which is why we're running at 25%. It all makes sense. Uh-oh, we got a problem. All this good stuff is backed up. That means something isn't fully connected to the awesome sink. But you know what? The last time I looked, this was going to be a 45-minute video. Now it's a 90-minute video. Let's call it there. We'll resolve our issues with storage and we'll get our director systems in place in the next video. Why is it? Now I have to check. No, this line is backed up. Right there, you can see the encased beams just sitting there. Uh-oh. Is this a failed sushi belt? Should we not have... Ooh. Ooh, this could be really bad. Don't have the materials for a splitter, but maybe I can make the rest of it work. Yeah, I don't think I'm supposed to have versatile. I wasn't planning on. I remember exactly the moment where I added these additional versatile frames to this belt. It's possible that that wasn't exactly correct. But since we've got it hooked up and it doesn't look like we caused any horrendous damage because we did have that smart splitter there, which kind of protected us. We'll just collect these versatile frames as they come in. Okay. If nothing else, this line is moving again. Phew. Good news. All right. That's that. Next episode, we'll get our assembly directors in place, and then we will... And in place means we'll get them shipped over to the hub here. Get them into the space elevator. Then we'll start building out what we need for the next project part. Not to say that we're done with directors, but we don't have to maintain it, right? We need to just build it and let it go, and it will generate the parts that we need on its own. Automation. Thanks for hanging out. I do appreciate it. We'll see you next time.